Shalom, shalom, akiyam. First and foremost, I would like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Kodash. I would also like to give a double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, where I learned this 144% truth. I would also like to say peace and salutations to the hopeful elect, starting with the 144,000 men of Israel, which consists of the servants of the prophets, whom have been ordained since the foundations of this earth to sing this new song, which comes in the form of this gospel, which would be preached throughout all four corners of this earth and rest upon the ears of the innumerable multitude, men, women, and children of Israel, who may be scattered throughout all four corners of this earth. It's just Bayan back again through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. And I just wanted to get into a brief lesson regarding this article I came across a few days ago. And, you know, you can imagine, man, with everything that's going on over there in the East, you know, the tensions of World War III, you know, Jacob's trouble, all right, and that the implementation of that MOTB in reference to Revelations 13:16, all right, which is that device the size of a grain of rice, okay, that implantable device, okay, that they're gonna have to put in your forehead and your head or in your hand, man, in efforts to bring you into the beast system, all right, it has to be right around the corner, you see, because we understand those prophecies gotta come first, and we know, you know, Jacob's trouble and the MOTB are pretty much gonna come hand in hand. But needless to say, those, you know, two major prophecies, they're imminent, man. They're imminent. They're coming into the perfection. It's imminent. It's got to be, man. Again, with the tensions that we're witnessing over there in the East. You know, so, you know, the Spirit led me to this article. Like I said a few days ago, you know, a lot's been going on. The Spirit's been moving. You know, but as of this morning, you know, the Lord brought it back to remembrance, man. You know, to bring this information out, you know, regarding the technology, okay, that Esau's gonna bring forth in order to bring evil upon you people, man. Okay, you see? And again, this is what we tell you, Jake, to repent. All right, we tell you to turn back to the Lord while you can. You're running out of time. We're trying to tell you that that door of repentance is closing each and every day. The sun sets and rises, man. You know? And you're going to find out in the days to come that you made a fatal mistake if you haven't returned back to your power as a so-called Negro, Latino, Native American, or speckled bird. You know that you may look like a heathen, you know, but your spirit resonates with this truth, but you still procrastinated on turning back and getting right. And you're going to find yourself in a position of difficulty, man, that you're not going to be able to get yourself out because you're going to need divine intervention and efforts to escape. Okay, and that divine intervention is only accessible, okay, to the Lord's elect. All right, Michael's not gonna stand up, okay, for a two-third Shita Jaka wearing nigga. No, man. Michael's gonna stand. Matter of fact, let's go get that. As a matter of fact, what's that? Daniel? Let's go get that real quick. In Daniel, we'll come back. Lord willing, we'll come right back. The book of St. Daniel, going right into the talking point, okay, of Jacob's trouble through the Spirit. The book of St. Let me see here. The book of Daniel, let's see, 12:1, right? And it reads, the book of Daniel, chapter 12, and verse 1, and it reads, and at that time, show Michael stand up. At what time? The time of Jacob's trouble, man. Okay, which is biblical and which is right around the corner. If you don't know that, you Jakes out there. All right? And at that time, show Michael stand up, the great prince which standeth for the children of thy people. And there shall be a time of trouble such as never was since there was a nation, even to that same time, right? Because now we're living in a time now where technology, okay, has come into its perfection. As it tells us in the same chapter, that knowledge shall increase. Okay, part of that knowledge increasing is technology, man. Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is going to give Esau the ability, okay, to bring forth weapons of mass destruction, right, in the form of them ICBM missiles. Right, he's gonna allow this man to be able to weaponize the air, the food, the water. Okay, and ultimately he was gonna allow this man to be able to play with AI, man. Artificial intelligence, man. In the form of transhumanism, super soldiers, and robotics, man. And this is the talking point we're gonna go into through the spirit, Lord willing. You know? This is all part of the terror. Okay, that Yahweh Bashim Yahushua is going to bring. Let's continue on. And at that time, thy people shall be delivered. Who? Everyone that shall be found written in the book. What book? The book of life, man. Spoken of in Revelations. Because if you're not written in the book of life, let's go get it. Bear with me. Bear with me. Salakia. The book of Revelation, chapter 20, and verse 15, and it reads, "And whosoever was not found written in the book of life," see that? And those are the elect. Those that are written in the book of life, okay, have been written in the book of life since before time, okay? They are predestinated to be delivered in these latter days, man. Foreordained. You see, this is why we hope and pray we're part of that precious number, man. Because if we're not, here's the result, right? And whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast into the lake of fire. And ultimately, that's when those missiles fly. Okay, via World War III. Okay, and thermonuclear fallout persists in the form of those ICBM missiles being shot and touching down, man. Okay, primarily right over here in the good old US of A, man, pursuing the biblical prophecy, the daughter of Babylon, man. Okay, this place is going to be the lake of fire you read about in Revelations. Because of the magnitude of missiles that are going to come touch down over here, man. In efforts to cleanse this land of the evil. Okay? John the Revelator heard 200 million warheads flying, man. He saw them. He heard them. Excuse me. You see? 200,000, man. Come on, man. So you can only imagine. And he also mentioned how he's seen the stars fall from heaven, man. He likened them unto stars falling from heaven. You see? The Lord gave John the Revelator the vision, man. It's going to be unbelievable, man. And if we're part of that elect, guess what? We're going to be standing on the sea of glass, which is likened unto the firmament, as we're in the chariot, okay, looking down. Okay, seeing that fire mixed with the sea of glass, man. That fire mingled. We're going to be seeing it. We're going to see the fall of our enemy, man. Close up and personal. You see? But this is the reality of this thing, man. Not everybody's being delivered. You see? Not everybody. See, Jake? This is what we're telling you to get right. So you can qualify to escape. Lord willing. Because when you read Zephaniah, it says, matter of fact, let's go get that real quick. It says, you may be. There's really no promises, man. Let me see, second chapter here. The book of Zephaniah, chapter 2, and verse 3, and it reads, "Seek ye the Lord Yahweh, all ye meek of the earth." And the meek is us Israelites, man. Okay, there's no power in our hands, man. All right. Ultimately, we've been placed in the position of meekness. Okay, where in reality, we're supposed to be in a position of authority, man, and sovereignty. But Yahweh Bashim Yahushua cast us down because we were disobedient. See? Which have wrought his judgment, right? And that word wrought goes into work. We have worked, okay, his judgment, man, in the form of these various captivities we've been in. And the history you can go in, proving our proving the atrocities that rested upon us, man. Okay? Giving more credence to us being that meek. Okay, look it. It's, the Lord's telling us to what? Seek righteousness. Seek meekness, man. Right? Be humble. Look it. It may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger, man. It may be. Okay? It's a possibility. All right? This should drive you to, this should drive you to fear, man. But you got to understand. The phone chimed in because you got to understand. If Michael doesn't defend you, if the Lord doesn't stand up and rise up against our enemies for you, man, you're going to fall victim, man. You're going to fall victim. Look, this is from Zero Hedge. And the title and the date is dated November 23rd, all right, 2024. The title reads, Terminator. Okay. Look at robot dog now equipped with amphibious capabilities. What's that mean? That means these niggas can swim now, man. Okay, that's what that means. Because when you get the... Look at, let's get this for edification. Right, when you get the... when you get the root word of the etymology of the word amphibious, it goes into what? Combining two qualities, right? In this case, what? Let's jump down. Living on land. Golly, this is the devil working. But look at down below here. Living on land and water. You see it? It won't let me highlight it. But anyways, right here, living on land and water. So these things can move around the land, rough terrain too, might I add. They've been equipped with the ability to move around on some rough terrain, man. Okay? And water, where they'll be able to get you, you jakes trying to sneak in and out of the country, man. In the form of you migrants. Who you think they're going to use these things on, man? The people, Jake. You know? They mentioned how it's for the battlefield, X, Y, and Z. But you know how Esau dresses things up, man. Come on, man. You ain't fooling us. You see, we're not ignorant of Satan's devices, man. Look, let's get some of this article. Let's get the whole thing. It's only this little piece right here. But look at this nigga right here, man. And these niggas are quick. And look at that. Yeah, you see it. Yup. Yeah, uh-huh. You see that. Anyways, let's get this real quick. Right? The use of robotic dogs on modern battlefields in Eastern Europe and the Middle East has expanded rapidly. Over the past decade, we have thoroughly documented their growing presence and proliferation. The latest quadruped robot design for modern warfare is the Ghost Robotics V60. However, this is far from a typical robotic dog. A separate defense firm, Onyx Industries, has equipped the V60 with autonomous maritime mobility system, enabling it to navigate rough terrain and traverse bodies of water, man. All while carrying a machine, Blicky. Okay? Come on, man. Where you? What you gonna do when this thing's on your ass, man? What you gonna do when this thing's on your ass? When it can navigate rough terrain and swim better than you? Okay? And it got you on the Scorpio. Okay? With that machine, Blicky. You see? You're going to need divine intervention to be able to escape this Terminator, man. And this is just one of many. This is just one of many, man. Evil E has things that he's not putting out there. That he's going to release. Okay? When the time comes. When the time is right. When Yahweh Bashim Yahushai wants to bring this terror. You see? Again, this is why we constantly warn you, Jake. Repent. Get right. Okay, or guess what? You're gonna get caught blindsided. You're going to get caught blindsided because you weren't paying attention. Because you weren't measuring the times diligently, man. Okay, matter of fact, let's go get that and we'll close out. The book of 2 Esdras chapter 9 and verse 1, and it reads, "He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs pass," which signs go into tokens, which I have told thee before. And how do you measure the times? You measure the times through the oracles, which are what? The prophecies, man. But in order to do that, you gotta have the vision where you will be able to hide yourself, as it tells us here. The book of Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 3, and it reads, "A prudent man," which prudent goes into wise, right? So a wise man foreseeth the evil and hideth himself. Again, to be able to foresee, that means you have foresight. That means you can see ahead of you, beyond, out over, out and beyond. You can see into the future, for a lack of better words. You see? And this is something that the hopeful elect have been given the ability to do. This is why the hopeful elect are turning to the Lord fervently, man, hoping and praying that we're protected by him when the time comes where evil and only evil has come. See? And hideth himself. But the simple, the stupid, pass on and are punished, man. You see? Punished, man. Let's go back. Con. Why? As a matter of fact, let's get one more. Why are they punished? Again, going back to the Talmud, because they have no vision. Proverbs 29 and 18. Where there is no vision, okay, which goes into oracles or prophecy, man. The ability to see in the future. Where there is no vision, the people perish, man. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he, man. Hey, so count yourself blessed, man. Akiyam and Akwaf. That we've been given the ability to see. We know what's coming. And we're preparing ourselves through the Spirit in efforts to be hid in the day of the Lord's anger. Back in 2 Esdras chapter 9 and verse 2. "Then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made," man. And we're in that time. We're in that time, man. Okay? And don't think you're going to be able to escape, Jake, because there's going to be nowhere to run. And there's going to be nowhere to hide. Let's close out right here. The book of Ezekiel chapter 7 and verse 5. And it reads, "Thus saith the Lord power, Yahweh, and evil," which evil goes into bad times. Evil is times. Ill is bad. "And only evil, only bad times, behold, is come. And end is come. The end is come. It watcheth for thee. Behold, it is come. Repent, Jake. The kingdom of heaven is at hand." All praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, where I learned this 144% truth. Lord willing, you Akiyam and Akwaf were edified. Shalom.